down. Rogue Stinger Hive detected.
Hey, what's going on YouTube? It's Tony the Trashkin here, coming at you guys with my first build video for TU8. This is going to be my LMG build that I'm using this patch, otherwise known as the Blackout build. We're using the Gunner Specialization. The Gunner Specialization works really well with LMGs this patch because it grants me a lot of ammunition, and once I start stringing kills together, my rate of fire goes up. I'm using two MG5s. Both of them have got strained. If I can find better rolls for them, obviously I'm going to want those, but the MG5s are really, really, really good with this build. It's a crit build, so I'm using the Coyote's Mask. The Coyote's Mask, it offers you per different meter ranges, different crit hit or crit chance attributes that you can get for you and your team, so it's great to use in a team setting. And then we've got like a god roll crit hit chance and weapon damage on there with some critical hit damage mods. We're using Providence Defense, three pieces of it, because it gives us crit hit chance and crit hit damage. And I'm running Obliterate. So Obliterate, you could either run Obliterate or Spark with this build. I like Obliterate better because sometimes you won't always have your skills with you. I'm using the Seska Viroba holster. This is giving me crit hit chance, and it's also giving me crit hit chance from the attributes, weapon damage, and critical hit damage. Providence Backpack, I'm using status effects. It's either going to be the bleed from the Seeker Mine or the confuse from the Banshee Pulse. So Wicked, you just get an instant 20% multiplicative weapon damage, so it is awesome. We got the Contractor Gloves. I need some better ones. I like the weapon handling, but if I could have armor, the damage to armor and critical hit damage, I'll get my critical hit damage up. So definitely we'll be looking for those. And then the Providence Knees also would be looking for something with more critical hit damage. I like the armor. I like the critical hit chance on there. Just need more crit damage. So here's the skills. I've got the Big Seeker Mine because it adds the bleed status effect, so it procs Wicked whenever I use it. And I've got the Banshee Pulse, so this makes people stumble and trip over themselves, confuses them, whatever you want to call it, and that also procs Wicked. So the reason why I like running the Seeker Mine and the Pulse together is because the Seeker Mine, you can flush people out from behind cover. And then the Banshee Pulse, if somebody's pushing you really hard, you can hit them with it, confuses them. Pistol's not really that important, just showing y'all that I've got like a named Perfect Breadbasket 1911 or whatever that is. And here's my stats. So I'm doing a little over 84,000 weapon damage, and then it's like 37,000 PvP. I'm doing 127 critical hit damage and about 49.3 critical hit chance. The reason why I'm not running 60% critical hit chance is because I'm running the Coyote's Mask, and I wanted to stack more into critical hit damage because in that mid-range, I think it's 15 to 25 meters or something, you're getting 10 critical hit chance and 10 critical hit damage, so I wouldn't gain anything from having 60% critical hit chance. This update, I've noticed a big thing is people are running lots of status effects and stuff. I might make a hazard protection build, but I'm not really sure how I'm going to go about that quite yet. I just know that hopefully there might be a patch that comes out sometime where the status effects aren't as strong, because I know most of y'all probably already know, like, your health gets chunked really bad by these bleed and burn status effects right now. This build doesn't really have a lot of hazard protection. I might make a hybrid or a blend of some sort where I can run this LMG setup with a little bit of hazard protection to keep me from getting my health chunked as hard. But I mean, right now that's really the best I can do. So definitely watch out for some more videos. Please like and subscribe. I hope you guys enjoy. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask me. And yeah, just get out there and just, you know, enjoy making builds, man. I love making builds and stuff. So yeah, throw me some ideas in the comment section. Appreciate it, guys.